Okay, so we're gonna be doing Star Wars versus Harry Potter. I hope Star Wars wins. Let's get on with the death battle.
Every generation has idolized a sci-fi hero, like Luke Skywalker, Legacy of the Jedi, and Harry Potter, the boy who lived. He's Wiz and I'm Boomstick, and it's our job to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to find out who would win a death battle. As the orphaned son of Darth Vader, Luke Skywalker carries the blood of the most powerful Sith Lord ever known. He was raised by his
I think I'm taller than him.
Saved by disguising his true
Ryan, 1 inch.
Taught by a wise old mentor in the ways of the Force. Luke's weapon of choice is the
lightsaber. I don't think Mara Jade's canon anymore.
Swords and lasers. Despite having little formal training, Luke advanced in lightsaber combat much faster than any other Jedi. He even took down a freaking TIE fighter with it, only a month after he blew up the Death Star. What a badass! Luke is a master of Form 5 DM So, an aggressive combat stance with defensive posture, specializing in both perseverance and pressuring an opponent. Despite what you might think, the lightsaber isn't just for killing. It also works pretty damn well for defense. Even so, Luke's most instrumental tool is his unrivaled connection to the Force. He can apply it in three aspects: control, sense, and alter. Controlling all aspects of the body, sensing and utilizing his surroundings, and altering the environment. Like the mind trick thingy. Oh man, the terrible things I would do with that.
When he's
exhausted, he can push his physical limits with the Force body ability and use flash burn to neglect pain until he can mend his wounds with Force heal. Also, Luke uses the Force to move things with his mind with almost no limits. Finally, Luke can use Shatterpoint to identify.
Just to pause really quick, how does Force heal even work?
By any possible weakness or fracture in a subject. Add just a little pressure with the Force, and boom, they explode faster than a Firestone tire. Luke has defeated a wide variety of foes, ranging from stormtroopers to deadly Sith Lords, one of which Luke had to construct a second lightsaber to beat. His shorter red Shoto saber was made to counter the Sith Lumia's light whip, and it worked pretty damn well. He still carries it, though prefers a single blade over two-handed combat. Penis joke. Anyway, Luke doesn't have an obvious weakness, aside from some pretty serious daddy issues. He doesn't carry a blaster, but unlike other stupid Jedi, he isn't afraid to use one.
Yeah.
While Luke is no fan of violence, he certainly will not pull any punches.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.
As an orphan, Harry Potter carries the talents of the most powerful dark wizard ever known, Lord Voldemort. He was raised by his aunt and uncle, who kept him safe by disguising his true powers before being taught by a wise old mentor in the ways of magic. Now why does that sound familiar? Harry wields an 11-inch Phoenix Core Holy Wand. He has learned numerous spells and is exceptionally skilled in charms. His trademark attack is the disarming charm, Expelliarmus, or whatever. Expelliarmus. Which can either knock a weapon away or throw the opponent through the air. The Confundus charm temporarily confuses
him. Hold on, I gotta reach my headphones really quick.
Target, stupefy stuns people, and the shield charm protects Harry from all attacks. And he can summon anything he wants to him with Accio. Accio money! Accio loose women! Damn. His firebolt is a racing broom that can reach 150 miles per hour in less than 10 seconds. That's even faster than Wiz gets shot down by a woman! Right. Wait, no, back to spells. Harry is also experienced in curses. He destroys objects with Reductor, slashes enemies with Sectum Sempra, and controls minds with Imperius. And then there's the killing curse. Abracadabra. Avada Kedavra. Oh, that magician wasn't trying to kill me. I guess I should probably go apologize to his family. While Harry's never actually used the killing curse, it is implied that he can. It is an instant kill and unblockable. Unless it hits a wall, or a sword, or anything, really. Almost all magic requires a line of sight and eye contact to perform. The killing curse is no exception. Harry also knows teleporting and can do it without a wand. His training in Occlumency defends his mind from any sort of mental attack or illusion. And he's got all sorts of other spells, but I seriously doubt the tickle charm's gonna help him much in the fight, so let's move on. Harry owns the Cloak of Invisibility, an unrelenting deathly hallow that hides the wearer from sight and cannot be detected. Unless he makes a noise or pokes his foot out. Harry is a quick draw with his wand and has performed many great feats at very young ages. He has also mastered non-verbal spells. By the time he was 17, he was beating up way more experienced wizards. In the battle for Hogwarts, he had no problem kicking a ton of Death Eater ass. Not to mention Lord Voldemort himself. Afterwards, Harry became head of the Dark Wizard Hunting Auror office, even though he's technically a Hogwarts dropout. He never did finish that seventh year. But I guess if you kill the Lord of Ultimate Evil, you get a GED.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
All right, the combatants are set. Let's end this debate once and for all. But first, let...
I think that Luke's gonna win. Because, you know, he's a Jedi. Yeah.
Confundo. Stupid.
You blew.
Sectum Sempra.
Oof. Oh, jeez. Yes.
Man, Harry did a surprisingly good job keeping Luke at a distance. But Luke fought smart and tried to finish Harry quickly with Force Persuasion. But Harry was able to resist thanks to Occlumence. Then Luke used Force Choke to stop Harry from casting spells. And although Luke could dodge the Avada Kedavra, the instantaneous Sectum Sempra curse caught him off guard. But with Shatterpoint, Luke discovered an exploitable flaw. That famous lightning bolt scar, which forced Harry to lose the battle. The winner is Luke Skywalker.
Called it. See you in the next one.